the prettier we're gonna look.
Is that Ron?
Ron Walker, how are you?
How are you?
I'm good.
Happy to see you. Well, I think it's you.
Yeah, it's me.
You look gorgeous. You probably wouldn't recognise because I've lost so much weight.
We both shop at the same shop, obviously.
But you wouldn't recognise I've lost so much weight.
I know you have, haven't you?
What
have you been doing? Diet pills again?
I've just been like living my life.
I remember back in the 90s you used to do diet pills, and I thought, oh, Candee lost all that weight. What's those pills?
I've like, done everything trying to lose weight. I did diet pills. I did pregnant women's urine. At one stage of the game, I used to go out to queue and was injected with pregnant women's urine.
My God.
And that's true story.
Is that a real thing?
It's a real thing, yeah. Anyway, but look, we're waiting. We're on the way to DT's. I'm excited. Are you excited?
So, yes, I am. And I guess what we should do is tell the viewers. Hello, viewers.
Hi, viewers.
This is Ron Walker. Now, you might know Ron as Miss Candee.
Well, yes. Now, tonight I'm actually going to... what I'm going to say is I'm going to look a little older than perhaps my fans, and I'm using the word fans, might like. But you're going to see a different version of me through the fabulous Stephen Anderson and his wonderful program. What's it called again?
Oh, I don't know, I can't remember. Well, I don't
Real
know.
Real Jack Principal. Anyway, look, it's going to be fun. I think we're on a fun journey tonight. I mean, I can't wait to catch up to Nova, the gorgeous Susie, and the fabulous Tabitha, and the rest of them.
And the rest of them, yeah. Right. And it's going to be good, actually, because, you know, we always see you on the stage and we chat with you. This is going to be a different sort of expose of what the person behind Candee is like. You're going to allow me to be in the dressing room with you.
Yes, it's kind of like that. Yeah. Unfortunately, I haven't shaved my head, so the grey hairs are coming through, but that's okay. But
it's all right, I think they look, that's nice.
I'm allowed, it's okay.
You're a silver fox.
I'm a silver fox. I'm a daddy. Actually, I should...
daddy and a mummy are rolled into one.
The thing about the lockdown has made me reassess myself.
Yeah.
And how I see myself.
All of us, actually, I think.
I think that's the whole thing. We're just different. You come through it differently.
Yeah.
You're not the same, and you'll never be the same. So
now, I really look forward to you talking to me when you're getting your makeup done, because I presume you won't have your mask on, and we will be able to actually hear you. Do you find it really hard to hear people in the shops when they talk to you?
Well, I hear, but I wear glasses as well. But
me too, sometimes.
The glasses, it's all just too wrong.
You're fogged up eyes, you can't lip read them, you can't hear them. You've got to stand 6 feet away from them.
Yeah, Jared, I'm finding masks really, really sexy. I'll talk about that in the dressing room, but because they are sexy. Now you look at people's eyes and their bum.
I agree.
I'm going to, my whole thing about 2020, I was actually chatting to Barbara Quicksand tonight. I rang Babs, and she's got one thing, and I think I love what she said to me tonight. Let's make, 2021, let's make drag camp again.
Made drag camp again.
And I think that's the way to, we have to fly with it.
And here comes that tram, we'll continue this. You got your supplies for
it's my makeup.
Your makeup box for you. I think we're going to go to the next one, Candee. Ron.
It's my makeup.
Do you get called Ron Candee, Candee, Ron Candee?
It'd be like that.
What's the PC way to do it?
There's no PC. It's whatever you think is right.
I think this one's the door. I don't know, he's in there. Or is it this one?
Can I see how it looks when it's on the full screen or not?
I can't do that until Nova comes up.
Yeah.
She hasn't come in yet.
So, well, we've got 19 minutes.
Yeah, you've still got 20 minutes until she starts.
Have you messaged her?
Yeah, she's still on the send the link.
Hi, how are you? Lovely to see you again, Stephen.
Lovely to see you again too, Ron.
Now, look, I know that I did say I had given up booze. Well, I have, but tonight is something very, very special. Because I haven't done drag since my birthday bash, which was in March 15th.
When you were 66?
I was 66 and still fabulous.
And so, still, and here you are in 2020, matriarch of Melbourne, 66 years old. Good on you. We love you for it.
Thank you. So I'm excited about doing something again because I just hope I remember how to do it.
Yeah.
You know, I hope it's just like riding a bicycle.
It will be.
I was never very good at riding a bicycle, just quietly.
Did you put the seat on?
I always put the seat on. But, yeah, so tonight you're going to see me perhaps a bit differently than what you'd normally see me. And that's okay, I think. You know.
I think it's actually quite nice to see you like this because, you know, people in the industry get to see Candee, see Ron. And I know Ron, and quite a few of us around know Ron, but quite a few of us know you as Candee as well.
Yeah.
And that's something I particularly want to ask you. Is there a duality? You're wearing the two faces. There's the face of Ron and the face of Candee. And sometimes I always try to make it, if you're out of drag, I call you by your boy's name, and if you're in drag, I call you by your girl's name. What is the right way to do
it? There's no right or wrong. There isn't. Because sometimes what happens is you cross over, and it's the way it is, you know. But I've always had, like, you've known me for years, and I've always had a very straight day job.
Yeah.
But I've managed to, at the night, do this. And, there was times when I was doing it, like, four nights a week, and still having a day job, you know. As I get older.
And drinking all together way out of the morning as well.
But everybody drank. It just wasn't just me.
I know, it was the 90s.
That was the whole way we did it. It was also the 80s and the 70s.
Yes, it was too. And the 60s too.
For me, but you know, I've been around for so long.
Yeah.
And I've been around for quite a few reasons. And I think when you do drag, you get to a point where you're done, you've had enough. You work at a venue for so long, you're done, you had enough and you leave. And I've done it so many times. You know, I left the exchange because I was sick of it. I'd had enough, I'm done. Then I got called back, you know. Because the thing is, we are these people that love that as well. You know, I'm talking about the performers. We absolutely love getting on stage. And okay, if the money's fine, but you don't quite often do it for the money.
It's playing the part.
It's the character you create. And I created this character at Inflation many, many years ago, you know. And you can't change the name halfway through. You can't change anything halfway through. They see this and that's it.
Yeah.
But on the upside of it, and when I've done, like, okay, let's go to the 80s, 90s, 2000, I started doing drag when I was 21, so, you know, that's a long, yes, 40 years or something. So the whole thing about it is that I've entertained people all those years, and those people that started out, you know, at a certain age, you know, they used to come into the hotel, and I get it all the time, people come and say, you were the first person I saw on stage, whatever, you know.
Yes.
You were the one, you know.
You are definitely one of those people that you're a lot of people's landmark drag queen.
I think that's the whole thing. But the thing where I've managed to be able to reinvent myself so many times that I'm still popular. If that makes any sense.
Yes.
What happens in it is that each era, when I first started out, I was the fat, funny one that did the punchlines to all the shows. When I worked with Kerry LaGore, who taught me so much about how to do it properly.
you know, and then I did that for 7-10 years or something. Then I did the Exchange Hotel with Barbara Quicksand for 10 or actually even longer, because that association is about 30 years. You know, and Susan, people see like Susan and I here as just the, you know, we just met each other like 6 years or 7 years. We've worked in shows for 25 years together.
Yeah.
People don't understand that. Tabitha, the same thing. You know, Tabitha used to come and watch me perform when I was in the Lipsticks.
You know, and now that I'm hearing you recount these stories, I remember watching you at the Exchange. I remember watching all of the names you just mentioned in different places all through time, because I've been around since Mandate.
Yeah.
You know, in Melbourne. So, you know, and we forget, because we, as we travel through from time to time through the decades, we stay in that decade. But there's all this history. So I see a lot of people that come to see you, particularly here at DT's, a lot of older people that have seen you and they've been with you through those decades.
Yeah.
So,
but what's kind of happened is that I had those people that liked me, and now, you know what the gay scene's like, and the hotels and all that. People move on. As they get older, they move on to another venue.
Yeah.
So the people that saw me originally have now gone to the Laird.
Yeah.
You know. But now I've got a new lot of people.
Yes.
So what happened, where I used to appeal to old queens and lesbians, now I've got young queens, old people and lesbians.
Because they've not seen you before, and the new one's coming up.
And they get it.
Yes.
It's about getting it. And, you know, this thing about lockdown, what it's said to me, and I'm not one of these people that do Facebook and watch it every day and look at it every day and whatever. But without a week goes by, there's 30 people wanting to be my Facebook friend. And I'm not a great Facebook friend. I'm not one of these people that are going to send you birthday wishes and say, really know you. You know, my thing, I think I've got like 2,000 or 5,000, whatever. I don't know how many thousand Facebook friends I've got. But I've only got like 20 friends.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? So it's different.
Yes.
And but what has happened, I think, during lockdown for me, is that people have seen my stuff on YouTube or wherever, and probably through your...
Real Drag Queens,
the Real Drag Queens of Melbourne. And so they get it. And I think the thing is, with DTs, and I've been here for, I don't know, a few years, six, I don't know how many years, but people come in and they don't get it at the start, but after they've seen you a couple of times, they so get it.
Yes.
They so get the camp, and they so get... And they're on your... On your way of it. Does it make any
yes,
sense?
Yes, because the product that you offer is camp.
Yeah.
It's a camp character, yeah. And that character doesn't change. And that character is a true character. It's true to your personality. It's true to your humour. So that follows through all the way through, and it has done through the decades.
I think that's the thing. And I always say funny is funny. And the bottom line is, to me, it's about you can go out there and... you've got to have, first of all, before you even get out there on that big stage, you have got to sit here with people that you like and people that you get and have the best time with. Then that translator, if you're having arguments with somebody or it's a frozen, horrible thing in the dressing room, there is no way in hell you can get on stage
That's
and
right.
be, you know, it's all about the magic that we create, and I get it. I get the fact that people come in on a Saturday night, or when I was in the Lipsticks on a Thursday night, when you'd get 1,000 people in, or the Exchange Hotel in their glory days when we'd have 500 people in. You know, I get all that. I get it. It's their night out. It's their moment. You know, and I was that person. I remember, you know, I was, before I started doing drag in gay places, I was working in the straight ones. Like, I couldn't get a job in a gay venue. So I did Inflation. There was a place in Greville Street I did.
And back in those days, you would have been novelty.
And the Cadillac Bar. I did all of those things.
God, I remember you at the Cadillac Bar. You were so camp.
I was
so. You used to wear the most gorgeous gold crunchy dresses and lay in the bar drunk like a...
I was a different person. This is the non-drinking Candee. I've got hair again. Yeah, I feel a lot more feminine now. I was feeling a little bit butch. That's what I thought. It's quite right.
Yeah, it's just quite
And right. absolutely No Botox. This is, I'm a natural beauty.
I can't believe that.
I can't believe that.
Yeah, I mean.
That's all yours.
I'm gorgeous.
You sure you're not taped up under there?
No, I'm devastating. They're beautiful. Yeah, so I mean, I know while other young ones are probably a little bit sort of peeved off. Because, you know, at my age, I've still retained, A, my gorgeous athletic body, and also, of course, my wonderful skin and lovely hair. I've always been proud of my hair.
You've always
got a crowning glory. I've always loved my hair. Yeah. I love walking the beach and going like that.
Always had a beautiful head of hair.
I always had a beautiful head of hair. I'm very proud of my hair.
Yes.